Hi, welcome to NIOS studio. Myself, Dr. Yogesh Sharma, Ramgadiya College of Education, Fagwada, Punjab. Today, I am going to discuss use of mathematics laboratory and library for creative thinking in mathematics. The development of self-esteem and ethics and the need to cultivate children's creativity must receive primacy. This was recommended by National Curriculum Framework 2005, as creativity is one of the most important things sought in our world. In evaluations of the reasons for accomplishment and failure, creativity appears to have replaced intelligence as the focus of interest. Creativity is a topic that should be part of the mathematics program at all educational levels, but still, it's much neglected in mathematics classes because teachers are unaware and have not yet perceived its importance. Now, if creativity of such significance for universal development, then the question arises, what is creative thinking in mathematics? Creativity in arts, literature, and other domains of knowledge is closely linked, as envisaged by National Curriculum Framework 2005. Moreover, Gordon in 1961 has given due recognition to the different fields of creativity and remarked that creative invention is similar in all fields, the arts, the sciences, the engineering, and is characterized by the same intellectual processes. It means creativity is same. Creativity is same in sciences. Creativity is same in engineering. But main thing is how we promote the creativity. He further maintained that the link between generative thinking in the arts and the sciences is quite strong. What it means that the creativity is such a construct that we have similar things in different fields. Kapoor, 1997, made a point in saying that one of the purest forms of creative effort is in mathematics. Moreover, Kapoor said, creativity in mathematics is of pure nature. It does not greatly depend on availability of equipment and on the complexity of social phenomena. In other fields, creativity may depend upon availability of equipments. Creativity may depend upon complexity of social phenomena. But mathematics is such an subject that it does not need any other aspect. Sri Raman said that the earliest known attempts to study mathematical creativity were an extensive questionnaire published in the French periodical in 1902 and a lecture on creativity by renowned 20th century mathematician Henri Poincaré. After that, various mathematicians, psychologists, and educationists try to explore the meaning of mathematical creativity or creative thinking in mathematics. Now, question is what creativity is? Hadamard identified the ability to find key research questions is an indicator of exceptional talent in the domain of mathematics. When we are able to questions in mathematics, when we are able to pose questions in mathematics, that show that we are creative. If a student is able to pose, he is a creative person in mathematics. Haylock, 1997. Mathematical creativity is the ability to break from mental sets, overcome fixations, and production of many varied and original responses in open-ended situations in mathematics. Overcoming fixation is sometimes we keep on doing the work in same way, but the solution is somewhat different. When we are trying to solve a problem with a similar methods in a similar way, the solution may not come. Overcoming fixation is such thing that we need to solve a problem with some different methods. Ernest pointed out that mathematics is a social institution resulting from human problem posing and problem solving. So it want to say that mathematics results from two aspects, problem posing and problem solving. Sharma has given the common characteristics of creative thinking in mathematics based on various analysis of definitions, based on various recommendations on creativity in mathematics. He has given certain characteristics. What these are? The ability to overcome fixation in mathematical situations, the ability to formulate mathematical problems, the ability to solve a mathematical problem with multiple solutions. Cultivating primary school students' creative thinking in mathematics should not be bound to the traditional classroom. Vail and Barbosa pointed out that learning environments where tasks give students opportunities to use several strategies to solve and formulate their own problems may involve them in rich mathematical explorations, increase their motivation, and encourage them to investigate, make decisions, generalize, look for patterns and connections, communicate, discuss ideas, and identify alternative paths. And this can be achieved with the effective use of mathematics laboratory and library. Mathematics laboratory and library should be used in such a way that it promotes students' problem posing and problem solving ability. Now, use of mathematics laboratory and library in creative thinking in mathematics. First of all, we will discuss how mathematics laboratory can be used. Number one, we can say that first of all, there should be a separate room in the elementary school for mathematics laboratory. Although we say that there is very many paucity of funds and we have not enough rooms for students to sit in, but if we want to make use of mathematics effectively, if we want to teach mathematics effectively, first step is that we must have a separate room for mathematics laboratory. Second, the student should be made clear about the purpose of the work to be done in the laboratory. That is what it aims for, what we will do in the library, how many experiments we will do, how many models we will do, what measurements we will make, what methods we will use. So the purpose must be clear. Third is, the student should be encouraged to think and make new models. Most of the times, we ask students to submit models. But the models they submit, they usually purchase it from the shops. The use in mathematics laboratory lies that students must be encouraged to think and to make new models. They have to make the models in the library itself, and they should not purchase those from the bookshops or other shops. There should be necessary material available in the laboratory for conducting experiments that enhance creative thinking of students. The mathematics laboratory should have following instruments like set squares, protractors, meters, scales, like that. Then tables of squares, tables of cubes, then ready reckoners of taxes, ready reckoners of recurring deposits, ready reckoners of interests. Then there should be charts and pictures, charts of prime numbers, charts of odd numbers, charts of multiples of three, then pictures of famous mathematicians along with anecdotes. There should be many models. When we go through the NCERT books, you will find that there are large number of models given in those. NCERT publishes various manuals on laboratory, and each and every teacher should go through those manuals in order to find what models we can place in the laboratory and how students can make those models also. Then we should have overhead projector also. Then we can have some audio and video CDs. These audio video CDs are also available from NCERT. Then calculators, some books and journals, the books which students find encouraging, some puzzle books, some journals on mathematics, some journals on mathematics education. They may be mostly for the teachers, but students can also use them with the proper guidance of their teachers. Then computers and also portraits of mathematicians. So this is a necessary material that we must have in our laboratory. Now, while working on a project in the mathematics laboratory, the essence of cooperative learning should be maintained. Cooperation is very necessary. If we want to achieve, we should achieve it in a cooperative manner. And we can achieve more in a cooperative manner than we can achieve in a single manner. The two time-tested cooperative strategies that teacher can use in laboratory are Jigsaw 2 and STAD. In STAD, that is Student Team Achievement Division, students are assigned to 4-member learning teams that are mixed in performance level, gender and ethnicity. The teacher presents a lesson and then students work within their teams to make sure that all team members have mastered the lessons. Finally, all students take individual quizzes on the material, at which time they may not help each other. On the other hand, in Jigsaw 2, students are assigned to 4 or 5-member teams to work on academic material that has been broken down into sections. However, each student receives a topic on which to become an expert. Students with same topics meet in an expert group to discuss them, after which they return to their teams to teach what they have learned to their teammates. The students take individual quizzes, which results in team scores. So this is a way we can make use of cooperative strategies in the laboratory. Another effective use of library is, or the effective use of mathematics laboratory lies in encouraging curiosity of the students so that they feel free to ask any question to their teacher. As a teacher, we need to encourage students to ask questions, and we should never try to snub their curiosity. When children are of younger age, they ask many questions. They ask many questions about their environments. They ask many questions about their day-to-day life. But slowly and slowly, we as teachers snub their questioning habits. When a student asks a question in the classroom, "Sir or ma'am, how this has happened? Why this has happened?" we try to snub that person. Or ultimately, that children stop asking any question. And in mathematics laboratory, students may get many chances to ask questions. 7th point, we can say the students, either alone or in a group, should be asked to pose problems, puzzles for other students. As problem posing is one of the aspects of creative thinking in mathematics, and if we need to promote this in mathematics laboratory, students must ask questions. Students must ask puzzles in the mathematics laboratory. Students must ask other students to make a model that he or she only can think about. The mathematics laboratory should be used in such a way that encourages the culture of risk-taking. Risk-taking and creativity are significantly correlated with each other. There are large number of studies that shows that risk-taking and creativity are correlated. The students should be encouraged doing some innovative experiment or thinking about novel solution of a problem without worrying about the completion of the syllabus. The completion of syllabus is always in the mind, and that discourages us in doing various experiments that should be kept out of our mind, and we must encourage the culture of risk taking. The students should maintain proper discipline in the library. If there will be no discipline, there will be no learning. And the kind of discipline must be a self-discipline. Students should be motivated intrinsically in such a way that they come to library to learn and not to just pass their time. Although students should be given freedom to ask questions, think flexibly, and work originally in the library, there should be proper mentoring by the mathematics teacher so that library work is not a wastage of time. There should be proper guidance by the teacher. Teacher should be always available in the library as well as laboratory. The students in the mathematics laboratory are encouraged to generate creative ideas. Students, if you make original models, there will be a prize for you. Students, there is a competition, and in that competition, we wish that you present a most creative model. Then all students must maintain a reflective diary where they should write down the work done and experiences of the mathematics laboratory. Whatever we do in mathematics laboratory must be come in a black and white. We must keep a record of each and every thing. What experiments we did, what models we make, what charts we make, each and everything should be in the reflective diary of the students. So these were the various uses of mathematics laboratory. Now, how mathematics library can be used in order to promote creative thinking of in mathematics? The mathematics teacher should take keen interest in the organization and maintenance of mathematics section of the library. The library ambience should be attractive and comfortable. If we will make library attractive, if we make library comfortable, students will come there. If the library is too hot in the summers, or if it is too cold in the winter, students will avoid going to the library. The books selected for mathematics section of the library must be of high quality. The library should not be crowded with unnecessary low quality mathematics books. The thing is quality and not the quantity. Whatever material is available in library, that must be of high quality and that must be appropriate for kids learning, that must be appropriate for primary school children's mathematics learning. The principle of variation should be given due importance while selecting reading material for library. The mathematics section of the library should include reading material like Encyclopedia of Mathematics, textbooks of mathematics, Indian as well as foreign authors, journals, mathematics puzzles and riddle books, mathematics reports, Encyclopedia of Creativity in Mathematics, books on application of mathematics, tests for assessment of mathematical creativity. Also, there must be some books in the library on problem posing and problem solving. The mathematics lab teacher should help the librarian in selection of mathematics books and journals in the library. The mathematics teacher should also help the librarian in procuring the books. Whenever mathematics teacher finds some good books, whenever a mathematics teacher came across a good book in mathematics, he must note it down. He must try to note down from where that book can be procured, and he must place the order for that book with the help of teacher, other teachers, and with the help of principals, and with the help of librarian also. The provision should be made in the timetable for library reading and consultation. Each week, 2 to 3 periods should set aside for library work. There must be proper provision in the timetable. There must be regular 2 to 3 periods in a week for the library work. The students should be guided by the mathematics teacher in selecting books. The teacher should ask regularly about the material consulted in the library. No doubt, teacher should guide which books we can study, what topics we need to study in the library, what books we will find on what topics in the library. The teacher can organize some experiments or quizzes based on library work. But in order to find whether students are actually learning something or not, or they are just passing their time in the library, or they are just sitting idle in the library, teacher can organize some experiments or quizzes based on library work. The thing is that the library period should not turn into a leisure activity. The mathematics teacher, moreover, should display the arrival of new mathematics books in library on the bulletin board. The bulletin board can be in the mathematics laboratory also. The bulletin board may be in the college notice board also. But it is the duty of mathematics teacher to make sure that students know that there is some new mathematics books in the library. We need to be a good salesman. We need to sell mathematics, and not in the sense that for earning something, but in the sense to improve learning of the students. And for that, we need to make mathematics attractive. And for that, bulletin board can help us. Bulletin board can help us that there is a book in the library. Students, go and read that book. And whoever read that book first, whoever issue that book first, that can be given due acknowledgement. 10th, we can say that the library work should be used in such a way that it inculcates the habit of divergent thinking among students. The divergent thinking is very much necessary in our life, and the library work should inculcate these habits among students. There can be some activities that we can use in laboratory as well as library. There are many activities, but here just we are showing a glimpse of the activities. More you will go through the literature on creative thinking in mathematics, or the best use of library and laboratory, more activities we will found. But here certain glimpse, like the task one, the cherries. There are certain cherries. Find different ways to count the cherries. Write the numerical expression that translates the way of counting them. Task 2, the dots. Imagine that given figure is the first term of a growing sequence. Draw the next term. Write the numerical expression translating a way to calculate the nth number term of the sequence you have built. Then imagine that the growing sequence you constructed began with the second term. Draw the first term, construct as much sequence as you can. The expression, suppose that you are an elementary school teacher and you intended to propose to your students a problem that could be translated into numerical expression. 3 multiply 5 plus 2. Invent problems that can be translated by given expression. These are the certain activities that we can use in mathematics laboratory or library in order to enhance creative thinking. Creative thinking is necessity, and that can be promoted by the effective use of library as well as laboratory. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.